Today is Monday. What's the date today? December? 5th, 2016. Yesterday, Sunday, around 4 p.m., this hamster came in with a complaint of rapid breathing. Not been eating since Saturday, 6 p.m., and was restless. Did not pass any poop. So if it's compared to the video yesterday and compared to today, this hamster is much more alert. Come, let's weigh the hamster. And we just open up first. Actually, he was moving around just now. You see his respiratory rate. His respiratory rate is, no, let me take out the whole thing, the cover. His respiratory rate is back to normal. You can see that he's not breathing very fast if you compare to the other video. He's curious and sniffing around, and it has some stools. Now I did give him some pellets. He's been shredded all the, he shredded all the tissue paper. Let me check any stools or not, any droppings. Okay, now we will weigh him first. They say it was 195, huh? 195. And this Syrian hamster is about 2 years old. It has to, the reason for this yellow, no, blood tinge fluid, which I think is either from the lungs. Yesterday I saw at 4 p.m. It's hard to say, but there was some rounds inside the lung cells when I auscultated. So it's about 173, yeah. Mm. 173. So I'll put it back. So it's going home today. So the diagnosis is likely pneumonia, and the injection given was antibiotics plus Lasix plus Hartman. It's about 1 ml subcutaneous, and I expect him to pass away overnight. But as you can see, he has a, he looks good, very inquisitive. Now, as what caused this blood tinge, I thought it was vomitus, but I think rodents don't vomit. So it's pretty surprising that the mouth was, could be saliva, full of saliva with blood tinge, either saliva or fluid. Now the lower teeth is a bit long, so I would trim it, and then it goes home. And according to the owner, this hamster is let free in the room, in the bedroom, and she allows this hamster to go and eat or gnaw at the cardboard boxes. Now cardboard boxes are for storage of things, and they are treated chemically during production of cardboard boxes. So it's possible this hamster could have chewed something hard from the cardboard boxes and injured herself. Now since everything is okay, so no more running around unsupervised and gnawing at cardboard boxes, and go home to rest. The owner observed the droppings. There should be at least 10, if not more, but as you can see here, there isn't any overnight. Any overnight? Or maybe there's one here, yeah. There's one. The droppings. The dropping is an indication of the hamster's appetite. Yeah? You can see more. You should see a lot of droppings in a healthy hamster, but can't see anything. Now this shredding of the toilet paper is a good sign, because the hamster is is active, yeah, overnight. Being nocturnal, she's more active at night. And I don't see any droppings. Now, hamsters, subcutaneous injections we do give, but I try not to, and unless necessary, because some of them may not take it. Although if we give small amount, should be okay. This is also given subcutaneously yesterday, B3 plus less 6 plus a bit of the Hartmann overnight. And you can compare to the previous video. This one is as bright and as normal as can be. So we go home today. Home this afternoon, you can see the nose is quite pink, and he has recovered from his rapid breeding. And this is his owner's carrier or house, his house. And you can see the owner does give some hay, I think, some hay. Then you have these seeds, the corn, and then the pellets. This is from the owner. So I put it on the floor, it's better. Then some biting blocks. So normally they put the feet deep into the bowl, which might be quite difficult for the hamster to access, because hamster will climb in. But you notice he likes to chew the seeds, huh? And now he's sleeping daytime. And overall, he looks okay. He climbed up himself. It was from here. Below, he climbs up to the top. Now, as you can see, the danger of this setup is that the hamster may slip and fall while climbing up to the top, because he could climb from this bars. From what I see, there's no way he can access it through the staircase. There's no staircase. So he could have fallen down. I mean, this is an old hamster, 2 years old, Syrian hamster. And the onset was sudden, the onset of not eating. Sudden on Saturday, came on Sunday. Saturday 6 p.m. came on Sunday 4 p.m. So it's possible there might be a traumatic injury to the chest when it fell down. You see, there's no other way he can go up. This is a poor construction. It's a bit too small for a house, and this one could be a bit too high for him, but it should be okay. He can stand. So overall, this one is okay for a young Syrian, not for the senior citizen. He's quite about 2 years old.